Okay, in this video, we're going to talk about derivatives of polynomials and exponential functions. So starting here in this section, we're just going to start looking at some of the shortcuts for calculating the derivative. So we're sort of going to leave the definition behind and just move on to a little speedier way of calculating these derivatives. So the first rule that we want to take a look at is the derivative of a constant function. So if you've got a constant function, f of x equals c, right, where c is just some number, a constant, then the derivative is equal to zero. And so here's a specific example. If I have f of x equals 7, right, then that's just a constant function. It doesn't have an x in there, and so the derivative is just zero. Why is that true? Well, I said we weren't going to talk about the definition, but the fact that the derivative of a constant function is zero just follows pretty easily from the definition. So here's the definition of the derivative, right? And f of x is equal to c. So no matter what the input is, the output is always equal to c. And so f of x plus h, right, is equal to c, just like anything else. F of x is equal to c. So on top, in the definition of the derivative, I get c minus c, which is 0. And 0 over h is going to be 0 no matter what h is, except for 0, right? And remember, the limit doesn't care what happens exactly at 0, just what happens when you get close. And so it turns out that 0 over h is identically 0 if you're not equal to 0. And that's a really easy limit. It just winds up to be, oops, put it there twice, it just winds up to be zero in that case. So the fact that the derivative of a constant function is zero pretty much falls straight away from the definition. So let's just take a minute and look at a really specific example of that and take a look at the tangent line. Let's just say f of x is equal to 4. I just pick that at random, that's a constant function. And let's just pick some random point on that graph, 2, 4, right? That would be a point on the graph of the constant function 4. And we can look at the tangent line at that point. Right? And we know that the slope of the tangent line is 0. And so really this whole side over here, right, just winds up to be 0, right? Okay, even though I wouldn't graph it in that case, so let me put the x minus 2 back in there. So so what we get for a constant function is that it's its own tangent line in this case here. So the tangent line, if I simplify this out completely, it would be y equals 4 for that one, and it will graph that one. So the constant function is its own tangent line. So. All right, the next fact that we are going to talk about is the derivative of the identity function. The identity function is just the function f of x equals x. And so you can see here in the theorem, the derivative of f of x equals x is just 1. Again, we can kind of go straight to the definition to take a look at that. And it's a really easy consequence of the definition. So here's the definition of the derivative, right? I'm going to plug in x plus h in here. And when I do that, I just get x plus h, right? Because for this function, the input is the same as the output here. And f of x is equal to x here. And so I can simplify, I get h over h, and that is equal to 1, right? Anywhere but 0. But again, the limit doesn't care what this is equal to exactly at 0. It's just what this is equal to when you get closer and closer to 0, but not equal to it. So for any value besides 0, this guy is equal to 1. And so that's, again, another easy limit. So I get that f prime of x is equal to 1. So one more time, let's just take a look at the derivative or the tangent line of this guy. And so I will get rid of these. And I'll pick, again, just some random point on the graph of f of x equals x. And I will look at the tangent line. So it's going to be y minus 2, right? The y coordinate of the point on the line equals, and the slope of the tangent line, the derivative, right, is equal to 1. And the x coordinate is 2. And so I see once again, right, for the identity function whose graph is a line, right, that the tangent line is also the line itself again in this case. So that happens for lines, but that's about it. When we look at the graphs of functions that are curves, which is most often, you know, what we care about when we're talking about this, we'll see that the tangent lines are not the same as the curve there. So that does happen for lines, but really not much else. So, all right, so that's about it for this part. I'm gonna talk about the rest of 3.1 in a couple other parts and then have a couple of example videos up there.